How do I begin writing? All I need is a subject. After that, my scripts do tend to write themselves. The subject has always been the difficult part. This time in particular, I found it very difficult to commit to one. None that I tried meant anything to me. None of them had any emotional resonance. They felt hollow. They felt forced.
After extensive research, I found one.
Not that the research helped, of course. The idea just came to me, as ideas do, when I was staring at my reflection in a mirror. Suddenly, it was so obvious. The perfect subject was me. I am fascinating. Everything about me is absolutely fascinating. Every word I say, every little detail is fascinating. How did we get on to this topic again?
I just asked you what your movie was about.
Ah, right. So naturally, I had a lot of material to choose from. The only difficult bit was to decide which part of my life the audience wants to see. Would it be Ashwin at home? Would it be Ashwin and friends? Would it be Ashwin the organ donor? No. It would be Ashwin the filmmaker. I decided to give my audience a taste of what it is I do. So I set my movie entirely behind the scenes of another movie.
What is that movie going to be about?
That movie is a behind the scenes documentary about itself.
Are the other characters in your movie also based on people you know?
That's an interesting question, because initially I did write another set of characters, but all of them were just wrong. None of them fit the movie. All of the characters, except for me, were just wrong. So I wrote them all out.
All of them?
All of them. And replaced them with me in their parts.
But how does that work?
You'll just have to watch and see, won't you? So you're interested in directing Quine?
Yes, I am.
Why?
Well, why not?
That's the spirit. We've been following your career with a considerable interest now, and we were particularly impressed by your last movie.
Did you like it?
Oh, stunning. Absolutely stunning. My assistant was in tears. Well, needless to say, old boy, you're hired.
It's obviously my filmography which impressed him. One of our hedgehogs is missing is a masterpiece.
He was cheap, and he took a paper.
I can only hope that the clip of Private Life you just saw is not going to upstage this entire movie.
Okay, this seems as good a place to start as any. Who is Ashwin?
I am.
Well, according to your script, so am I. And the producer as well.
Well, you're all just divisions of my mind. You are a division of my mind. You are the part of me that thinks like a director. I am the part of me that thinks like a writer. You're not so much a person as a metaphysical construct. At the end of the movie, you're the audience as well. That is a symbol representing the narcissistic urge of filmmakers to make movies only for themselves to enjoy.
You're hoping the audience will get all of this?
Oh, they will. They will. Right.
There's only really one part in the movie, so if we don't get that right, well, we're stuck right from the start. So, naturally, casting it was very difficult.
I'm supposed to be you, is that right?
Technically, yes, and the writer, and the producer, and yourself in some parts as well.
Oh, that's a little difficult to get my head around.
It wasn't working, it just wasn't working. And after a point, I think we really did get a little desperate.
Fortunately, in the end, we found him.
Yeah, Ashwin, right? Yeah, sure, we're almost ready. Do you need any time to get warmed up? We'll just start running in 10 minutes,
okay? Yeah. I hope this works. We've been trying to cast this part for ages now. Okay, let me understand. I'm supposed to be you. Is that right? Technically, yes. And the producer and the writer and yourself in some parts as well. That's a little weird. A little difficult to get my head around. Fortunately, in the end, we found him. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm supposed to be you. Is that right? Are you very particular about the title?
What, Quine? Yes.
No chance you'd consent to changing it then.
Why should we?
Well, face it, nobody's gonna understand what Quine means.
It's too late now anyway. The title's already appeared a few scenes ago.
Forgot about that.
The costumes were crucial, so I decided to experiment with something I like to call the Clark Kent effect.
So if I'm wearing glasses, I'm the writer.
Yeah.
And if I take them off, I'm not.
Yes.
And who am I if I'm wearing the cap?
I'm not sure. I guess I'll just have to go find out.
Okay, yeah, Ashwin needed on set.
Where is he?
Oh, I'm so sorry, I didn't recognize you there for a minute.
My assistants just told me about this movie called Adaptation. Have you seen it?
Yeah, it's a good movie.
It's a little similar, isn't it?
No, it isn't. The plot of Quine is completely different.
Frankly, I think the audience might think it's a ripoff.
Probably won't.
Probably will.
How about mentioning that movie somewhere?
How will that help?
Then it becomes an homage.
Brilliant.
Day 3 of filming, and we finished all the scenes of the producer and the meetings. So today we're filming the garden interview. Now, this isn't actually the writer's garden. He's very private about his garden. He calls it his sanctuary, so we can't really see it. In fact, his garden's just next door. You could probably take a peek at it if you... No, it's probably second thoughts. No. Never mind, forget about that. It's probably not the best idea. Anyway, we're filming the scenes of the garden between the writer and the...
Okay, I'm sorry for calling this late meeting, but in the early scenes in which you're being interviewed, who is interviewing you?
It's not important.
Yeah, but the star really wants to know. He says it's part of his process.
This proved to be a lot more difficult than we initially anticipated, simply because of the number of cameras that we needed. I mean, I should point out, this is my first movie. I'm normally a stills photographer. And that meant that I don't really have too many cameras. I mean, of these three cameras, this is the only one which even shoots video. That one hasn't even really worked in the last 10 years. So we needed some form of plan. Let me explain.
Thank you.
Imagine if we all actually did look alike in real life. It would be weird, wouldn't it?
Okay, we're officially into our last day of filming now. We're filming a sequence which is going to come a little later in the movie, which for obvious reasons we can't really show you yet. But wow, it is amazing. This scene is the scene which is probably going to make the movie. It's easily the best scene we've shot. Best scene we've shot today, best scene we've shot ever. Ashwin and Ashwin have really outdone themselves this time. I really can't praise this scene enough. It's just that good that even the suspiciously long build-up that I'm giving just doesn't do it any justice. Look out for it. The Marshland scenes is called. Marshland scenes. You realize we can't really use this.
What?
Well, for one, they're not really looking at anything.
Well, it's going to be added in digitally. I don't know, it just seems to be lacking in energy. There's the argument scene. You can't really get more energetic than this. I don't know, then maybe too much energy. It just isn't working for me.
I can't reshoot now. Cameras are gone, the star's gone. There's pretty much nothing I can do.
You're going to have to find some way of doing
it. Look, it's easy for you to sit there with your 4 minutes of screen time and your oversized suits and demand changes, but that doesn't make them possible.
Are you forgetting who's in charge here?
Is that a threat?
So what if I am?
I don't respond well to threats.
You know what? We should stop this. Can't you see where this is going?
I think the first thing we need to do is establish a system. I read somewhere about these two editors who used a bell at the end of every shot to signal to the other person that they're finished with it and, you know, sort of give them a sense of accomplishment. I think we should probably try that.
Yeah, I think that should work, yeah. Yeah, let's try it.
You can't cut there. You're cutting way too early. You're not even giving him enough time to finish his set.
Well, this product placement stuff is terrible. We really have to do this?
Yeah, we have no choice. Make it as prominent as possible. They were very clear about this. Okay, you know what? Stop this. You don't really seem to have got the point of the bell at all. Let's just abandon the bell. Just forget the bell ever existed. Won't happen again.
Scenes.
It's not like we had a choice.
They were the best scenes in the movie.
It's politically provocative, my boy.
Couldn't have possibly kept it.
That was the point. We were trying to make a statement. You agreed to this.
Do you want to know why they cut the scene?
Yes. Please.
You built it up too much in the previous scene. Nothing we could have shot could have possibly lived up to that.
Why could you just cut the build-up?
If we cut the build-up scene, we would have to cut this scene. And does it stop there? We would have to cut another scene. And little by little, we lose the entire movie.
No, there weren't too many arguments while making the movie. The only other major argument was the ending.
The originally scripted ending was meant to be grand. Sweeping cameras, fast audiences.
Unfortunately, we ran out of money.
And also, in the original script, the movie would be a critical success, but a commercial failure. It just wouldn't make any money.
It would then go on to develop a cult following. I didn't want a cult following. I wanted a hit.
I'm not rewriting it to be a hit.
Look, I'm on your side here, but there's really nothing I can do.
It doesn't make any sense this way. I don't see what's the point.
He thinks that if you give it a happy ending, more people will watch it. Make him more money.
What is this, the 1980s?
He really thinks it'll work.
Quine was unbelievable, especially the happy ending. The happy ending made me feel so warm and fuzzy, I saw it 6 times.
As underwhelming as the result was, I had to give them what they wanted. I did, however, have my revenge.
Quine, for most of its running length anyway, is good. The ending, however, collapses into a bit of a mess.
obviously, studio interference. I mean, you just have to see Ashwin's other work to be able to know this. It's so unstructured that even the brilliant, if I might say so, addition of the film critic character can't save it.
Quine was a very emotional experience, but a very rewarding one. I like to think of it as a journey into myself and back again.
So, have you got anything new planned now that Quine's been completed?
That's a good question. Yes, yes, I have.
Anything like Quine?
No writer likes repeating himself. So, no, no. What I do have is this wonderful thriller, all about this bank manager who decides to pull off a heist on his own bank. Ah, but the interesting bit is, all of his team, all the bank employees and all the investigating cops are all the same person.
How does that work?
Well, you'll just have to wait and see, won't you? By the way, who are you?
Views on a behind-the-scenes documentary for Quine.